If you don't have anything to hide, you don't have any reason to run. Hey, here I am.
No, I don't think so.
Really? I guess I'm an active shooter.
I'm gonna take a call here from Joe Donna.
Okay.
Hi, Joe, can you hear us?
Yes, hi, how are you today?
I'm good, how are you?
Well, I was hoping you could help me figure something out. What do you think would be a worse situation? This Cuomo governor trying to talk to the 18-year-old, or Joe Biden sticking his finger up a girl. And remember, he had admitted to that. Do you think maybe people should have investigated that?
Well, I think both are terrible scenarios, and hypothetically, I would not choose either if I had a choice. But thank you for calling in, Joe. So we've got Guido. Hi, Guido, are you still there?
Hey, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I think Cuomo got what was coming to him. I think we all know he's a lying scumbag, and I mean, I applaud them getting rid of him. We knew he was a lying scumbag when he kept doing his little press conferences. He's a fake. He's a phony, and he's a fraud. And another thing, I'll tell you what, Hunter Biden, this guy, you talk about degrading women. Every time I see this guy, he's got two prostitutes with him and a crack pipe in his mouth. I mean,
whoa. Let's rewind that a little bit.
Fran, are you there?
Oh, yes, I am. Hi.
Hi, Fran. I like your energy this morning.
Yay.
Oh, yeah, I've had a lot of caffeine. First of all, when Guido called, I just recognized that voice. I've been listening to WMNF for a long time, and you know, you get to recognize some of the, I guess you could call them trolls that call. I don't know what his prior aliases were on the other talk shows, but he's had a lot of them, this guy. But I recognized his voice. So, you know, just...
You know, Fran, you're not the only one. I'm getting other messages in our text messages saying... And you know what the funniest part is? It says he made a bet at the time, $500 bet with somebody that Trump would win, and stopped calling in because he never paid up.
Oh, yeah, now it comes back. Oh, yeah.
I hope that jogs your memory.
Yeah.
All right, we can take, let's see, Anthony from Ybor City. I love Ybor City. Anthony, are you with us?
Hey.
Hey.
Hi, how are you?
I had a chance to throw my shoe at Trump. I might take it. But the thing is, people are just not treating others fairly. And that's why people have to call in as, you know, another person. If people would just be indiscriminate over the years, then other people wouldn't have to call and waste people's time. You see what I'm saying?
Kind of.
I'm not sure.
But yeah. And so we believe that women have agency over their bodies. And if they want to use their bodies to make money, more power to them. We will support them in that endeavor.
But obviously, I can counter if I can interject. Men have a domain over their bodies, too, if they want to make money out of beating people up.
Number one, when men beat people up, somebody gets hurt.
I mean, I think we need to back up a little bit and say that, like, men also have the agency over their bodies not to go pay for sex. Like,
right.
That's also immoral. Like,
yeah, and they can find some sucker out there, to take some money from.
Well, we clearly have a different viewpoint of it. They are selling experiences, and it's like if you think you're buying somebody who's going to fall in love with you for 10 minutes, then maybe you ought not be in the game.
But thank you for calling in.
Yeah, Kevin. Thank you much for calling.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye. I mean, from my perspective, it's where are your morals and ethics coming from?
So yeah, who says it's right? Yeah, some dude who wrote all the women out of the Bible decides that hey, this is immoral.
Yeah,
Jesus was cool with it.
Yes, great morning, ladies. This is DJ Smells So Good on the check in. Europe has sex shops on every corner.
Yeah,
has brothels. Forget this. We talk about, and this is in 1996. I was there. So we talk about the 90s. Oh. And they had women in the windows, clear glass windows, on display as you walk down the sidewalk in front of kids and everybody else. And their culture's just so open. It's not shunned. It's not people walking around. The news don't talk. Hell, the news be half naked themselves.
Right.
That's my point. I mean, if you get outside the box or think outside the box, I think the sex workers, because to me, you know what I'm saying, the increase of sex workers would decrease women getting raped.
Mm-hmm.
Men are going out there taking it because they can't outrightly just get it. If you had women out there, if you had competition out there, the price would go down, and men could afford to go and get their little pleasures, whatever they rocks off.
And Jesus stepped in and said, let he who is without sin cast the first stone.
Right, but that doesn't mean that woman wasn't in sin. And also, he's never condoned prostitution. He also judged the Pharisees, and he judged people that were religious and weren't basically following the law. And then
Nick, I think Donna has something.
Yeah, Donna's going to tap in with her Bible knowledge, which is far superior to mine. So,
okay. Nick, Jesus was good pals with Mary Magdalene, and we know what her history was. Then there was the woman at the well. There was the woman who wanted to touch the hem of his garment, who had the issue of blood. There were so many women in the Bible where Jesus said,
the woman at the well, let me just say this, the woman at the well.
Hold on, let me say, I did not interrupt you.
Basically pointed out to her.
No, Nick, you have to take turns. You can't talk over people.
And I will say this last thing. This is not the seminary. We know what the Bible says and doesn't say about judging others. And I think that we should just hold it right there.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Donna.
Sure.
Okay. Okay, can I say something?
Yes.
Okay, basically God is going to judge people, okay? And, Jesus basically told the woman at the well that you had seven wives and the one you're with now, you're not even married to. So he was pointing out that she was basically doing things that were not moral. And then... he told her, if you want to drink of the water of eternal life, and she said, I think that you're a prophet. And afterwards, he accepted Christ, but he never condoned the idea that what she was doing was okay.
Uh-huh.
You see, that's where you get off into saying that, oh, well, you can't judge. Well, eventually God's going to judge people if you believe in the Bible.
Well, thank you for calling, and I do think
And that's
that
a good
God,
point. If you believe in the Bible, if you believe the Bible is literal, if...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Also,
if the Bible is literal, then actually, if the Bible is literal, then banks are going to hell because loaning.
they're not going to be by themselves either.
Right, right.
It's going to be crowded down there, yeah.
We can do that.
spitball thing.
He's taken literally. I mean, he was a man who lived. It's the biggest seller ever in the history of the world, and it's a history book.
I think we've covered everything on that end, and what Donna said, sit with it, sit with the... Donna, what was your concluding point?
We're just going to hold it. We're not Jesus, and we're not God.
Yeah.
According to our listener, I'm sure believes that God sees and knows all, and if he does, then that gives him a superior aerial view of what everyone is doing, and he probably has the ability to judge it. Since we don't have that, I think we should abstain.
Yeah, we'll abstain, yeah.
Many of us in the diaspora kind of really trying to accommodate those folks.
Yes, I'm going to talk about that in a moment,
after all these years, all these dead people, whether in Afghanistan or U.S. soldiers or U.S. journalists or expertise or international volunteers who went to Afghanistan, and then it's going back to how Iraq is now, civil war and disaster. Let me go to this person in Tampa. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yes, at the heart of it, it's always been about the form of government, the vision of civil. And, of course, the Taliban is a religious form of law. And I would like to say I put my hope in them because they won't take the vaccine.
The Taliban?
Get out of here. Get out of here. You don't have any right to be in here. Get out. Get out. Get out.
This
Get
is
out
an independent investigation.
Right. Call the cops. Call
yep.
the cops.
You need to
this
leave right now. You need to leave right now.
This guy threatened me. This
yep.
guy threatened
yeah,
me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All the lies.
I've got
all the lies.
Out.
All the lies.
Call the cops.
Call the cops. Call the cops. All the threats.
That's why you wanted the address. Nice.
You think I'm afraid of a jail cell?
It's not about that. This no. is not you, the you, place
you,
for this.
You're the one that provokes aggression. You're the one that provokes
Thank
aggression.
Thank you very much.
And then
Thank
you want
you
to talk
much.
About active shooters.
Right there's the cop.
Call the police.
I'm already talking.
I want to talk to the police. Let's make this a public thing.
You need to leave now.
I want to make this a public thing.
You can wait outside.
Community please needs please. To know what's going on. That's all right. You haven't seen the last of me. The struggle will come to an end.